So, many have wondered, how did that bike get up there? Understanding why it's not because somebody rested their bike against the trunk many years ago means understanding how trees and forests really grow. So, how do trees and forests really grow? Forest managers are always asking questions like this about British Columbia forests, maybe not involving bikes, but many other really important questions about tree and forest growth here in BC. You see, sustainable forest management rests on our ability to predict how forest practices affect future forest growth and development. For years now, forest managers have been able to use computer-based growth and yield forest models for this purpose. One of BC's primary growth and yield models is the Tree and Stand Simulator, which we call TAS. Today, forest managers are probably most familiar with a derivative of the TAS simulator called TIPSI, which stands for Table Interpolation Program for Stand Yield. But I'd like to focus on the actual TAS model itself. What makes it tick, and what it can do for us. Back in the 1960s, a Yale PhD student from BC, Ken Mitchell, began using computers to simulate the growth of individual tree crowns and their competition. His goal was to predict silviculture response based on basic biological principles of growth and stand development. Tree crowns are at the heart of the model because they are the photosynthetic engine that drives wood formation and stand dynamics. Either individually, as in the pruning of branches to enhance wood quality, or collectively, as in the thinning of stands to reduce competition and redistribute growth among the remaining trees. And yes, this also applies to things like genetic improvement and fertilization. TAS focuses on individual tree crown dynamics by modeling competition for growing space and light in three dimensions. Given the long time scale of forestry, simulating basic biological processes like these enables us to explore new and innovative silviculture treatments with TAS long before field trials can provide data. Of course, we know that TAS, like all predictive models, is only an abstraction of reality. While its projections of future tree growth are never perfect, they still provide valuable guidance to decision makers. Since its adoption by the Forest Ministry in the early 1980s, TAS has been the primary source of growth and yield information for managed regenerated stands in BC. Before TAS, we used simpler models that did not reflect the impact of silviculture practices like planting, which can increase growth rates. We've been able to use to calibrate TAS to long-term forest growth data, thanks to BC's wealth of long-term, permanent, and remeasured experimental and sample plots, some dating back to the 1920s. In the 1990s, TAS enabled BC to become the first province in Canada to extensively apply planted stand yield predictions and timber supply analysis. The inclusion of thrifty managed stand growth enabled us to dramatically reduce the anticipated decline in long-term timber supply forecasts. TAS has been supporting the chief forester's allowable annual cut determinations ever since. Given TAS's emphasis on silviculture, the addition of investment analysis capabilities was a key collaborative effort for us. This project integrated log and lumber volumes predicted by TAS with economic analysis based on product prices and costs for silviculture, harvesting, and milling. The resulting tools are still used today to help guide and prioritize silviculture treatments to design silviculture treatments designed to ameliorate the impacts of mountain pine beetle, wildfires, and climate change. TAS is also a modeling platform to integrate forest research from various fields. This is achieved through collaboration with scientists from the ministry and other provincial, national, and international organizations. An example of this is the Douglas Fir Task Force of the 1980s, the first of many multi-institutional research projects focused in part on second growth wood quality and its management through silviculture. Other collaborative research projects with forest health experts have helped us to incorporate the impacts of various insects and diseases in task simulations, including spruce weevil, root rots, and most recently, pine stem rusts. As you can see, TAS is being used for much more than just timber production. Carbon and biomass projections from TAS are contributing to provincial and national climate change-related initiatives. TAS also provides key stand structural attributes to predictive models for many other forest values, such as winter habitat for deer and caribou, viewscapes along forested highway corridors, and forest cover needed to regulate snowmelt and runoff. TAS can also produce some pretty impressive graphics, as in this time-lapse simulation of repeated mountain pine beetle attack on a lodgepole pine stand. In recent years, much of our ongoing research and development is focused on the next generation of TAS, TAS 3. In the face of climate change, we're managing for resilience, in part by encouraging multiple species and greater complexity in stand structures. TAS 3 has been designed to address these types of conditions by introducing dynamic light modeling. Thanks to advances in computers and programming, TAS 3 is also the first version of the model that is available to users themselves. You can actually run TAS on your own desktop computer now. The initial release features lodgepole pine and white spruce, and we're actively working to add more species. You can find our free web download site by Googling Task Force Download. Ongoing collaboration is key to our continuing improvement of TAS. That includes working with other scientists, access to more long-term forest measurement data, and the continual feedback we receive from TAS users here in BC and elsewhere. We thank you for that, and thank you for your attention.